We found that this was most easily accomplished by splitting them up, which can be done by manipulating the gates around the side of the room. Basically, let one pass under the gate, then lock the other one out so you can beat up his pals. Tip, don't shoot the keeper in the head. It's got a giant box on it. No shit. In fact, that's likely where the nickname Boxhead came from. Instead, go for this guy's body, hitting him with a sniper rifle round, shotgun shells, and even a few explosive bolts. Fucking bucket. I mean, that's what I'm... I don't understand. They should die after all those explosive rounds. They should be dead. And yet... I don't know what's happening. Why are you dead? God. Oh, fuck. My kingdom for consistency. Fuck out of the water! Man, they have a weird obsession with shit that just like slows you down.
Out of ammo?
For everything? We're gonna make him twice as hard as the other guys, but have them look exactly the same as the other guys.
Ruvik, I created this world. You cannot keep me here.
And have two, right. Is this game, is it almost over? Is this the end? Like, how much time do I have left? Oh my god, a checkpoint? Wow. You get a real MVP game. Yep. No, take longer to get up! Please! Take control away from me for as long as you want. Yep, I do. Two? Can you actually take this off or you have to walk through them? No. Please don't forget that I have no ammo, game. Please don't forget. It's gonna be a short boss battle if they don't give me some ammo. Nami? Here's some pickle juice, but we're gonna take the chair away so you can't actually use it. Sucker! Fun times ahead. If the final boss battle starts and I have no ammo, then this is going to be one of those games where I'm like, I beat it! Go watch the ending on YouTube, because we're done.
If I make it out alive, I'm never riding in an elevator again.
Again. No, I have no ammo. I have no pistol ammo, no shotgun ammo. I've got the crossbow bolts, thankfully. Which, the bug is still happening where it's not updating the ammo count. If I cycle through it, does that work? There we go. Nope. Regular ammo is still bugged. Look, see? You actually have ammo. There we go. Oh, wait, no. Explosive ammo is still bugged. There we go. Alright. Yeah, they haven't... They just went through a major event with two super strong enemies that take a lot of firepower, and they haven't given me any ammo after the fact. So I guess we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. I'm sure there'll be ammo replenishment before the last boss. Don't worry about ammo.
Connelly. Kidman. Joseph.
Broseph.
Leslie. Dr. Jimenez.
Yeah.
It can't be.
Yeah, it's me, baby.
Help! Help!
Sebastian? Get away from him. Sebastian, listen to me. Stop. Your interests are the same as ours.
Look, I get it. You're not just some rookie detective, and this is not just some ordinary kid. You killed Joseph and you shot me. So right at this moment, that's enough reason for me not to trust you.
You're a good man. That's why I... Doesn't matter anymore. If you know who this kid is, if you know anything, you know why he can't be allowed to live.
Bullshit. It's Ruvik. He's the one that...
Leslie!
Good luck, have fun. It might be a QTE fest. There's evil within brains from the like the box, like the box cover. Got braces on. Oh, he just wants to have a smile that he can love. Good thing I juiced up stamina, huh? See who needs ammo. Oh, just pull yourself off. Yeah, give me the rocket launcher. Give me. Ballsack. Oh. Oh, that... Whoa.
I created this world. You cannot keep me here. Ruvik. I'm going to finish this. Sign, sir.
Leave that one. And those two. They're not going anywhere. No one can.
Go! Detective, are you all right? Is there anyone else?
Just give me some real fresh air.
hell.
Hope is dropped and lost.
What is the link? Post the link. Wait, hang on a second. Don't post the link again. Oh, there we go.
Sound is a twisted lullaby. Touches the size.
I finished the game this morning. Yeah, the plot is all over the place. It's extremely simple, yet it's extremely convoluted. Ruben Victoriano is a medical genius, right? But very weird. He lives with his parents and sister Laura. The villagers are angry at the Victorianos for stealing their lands. So they burn their barn, the children inside. Laura dies, Ruben is scarred and hidden by his father in the basement. After some time, he kills his parents and assumes control of their fortune. Ruben, now calling himself Rubik, makes progress on his research exploring the limits of human technology and linking minds together. That the attention of Marcelo and Carlos, back everyone. Rubik is propped up and plugged into a machine. Plugged into the machine quite at the end. Leslie, to humanity's latest test subject and his powers would enable Rubik to get back into the physical world. Offered by Poppy Mind, Rubik takes over the Egyptian mental hospital, setting up the beginning of the game. He takes over the mental hospital.
What?
Now, on to the questions. As far as I know, that subplot serves absolutely no purpose for the overall plot of the game. I was expecting both to tie together at some point, but what Mira uncovered seems to be completely unrelated to Rubik's plan. DLC, maybe? Everything regarding Kidman and Joseph's fate is left open to interpretation, or DLC, maybe. There's no clarification in the main game about what happens with them or why Kidman was sent to the hospital. The Keepers, much like every other special monster in the game, i.e. not a regular zombie human, is a personification of Rubik's feelings. They represent the fears that arose in him by Jimenez's stealing his research, hence the lockbox. The game's description of the enemy says that anyone who tries to open the box gets trapped by it, becoming a keeper. That would be Rubik's revenge for everyone who tries to steal what is his. I honestly didn't like the game. Its pacing is all over the place. The plot is fucking convoluted. The characters are pretty bland, and there's way too much action and very few puzzles. I was expecting something like a modern RE1, but instead I got a better RE6, which is not saying much. The story is junk, the writing and voice acting is bad enough that it's beaten down much. It's beaten down much that I've been trying to explore the hidden depth. He still has a headache, so why is he even still asleep? Or why is he awake? Or is he, can he be awake? That's interesting, huh? So, yeah, it had moments, but it definitely seemed like it was kind of all over the place. So wait, there is DLC for the game? Skip, hold right mouse button. Chapter 15, clear! Clear bonus, machine gun acquired. Clear bonus, rocket launcher acquired. Clear bonus, 50,000 skill points acquired. Pickle juice. Clear bonus, new game plus and model viewer can now be selected in the main menu. Clear bonus, you can now choose a different difficulty setting when selecting new game. Total clear time, 13 hours, 53 minutes, 57 seconds. Total number of deaths, 49. That was casual. Let us all play Elite Dangerous now. Play any chapter that you have saved upon completion. Model viewer! I mean, there are good things about this game that are, it's just kind of a, it's a shame that the entire package is just kind of... Eh. Sebastian. Trenchcoat Sebastian. Wait, what just happened? What? Casual my ass. Oh, there we go. Ho! How do I... Oh. Julie Kidman. Oh, whoa. Those are some fighting boots, some fighting shoes right there. Are those, what? What is she wearing? Oh, she went with the combat pumps. Nice. All the way. Small Kidman. Wounded kid. Wounded Kidman? Really? Why is that a... I... Okay. Nurse Tatiana. Seven at time of disappearance. Without Rome. Ruben's had a bad time. Ooh. Trauma. Sentinel. Oh, it is Laura. I had a feeling this was Laura. A creature born from the memory of Laura's tragic death and Ruvik's own vengefulness. The thing is nearly immune to bullets, but reacts violently to open flame. Quell. A creature generated by Ruvik's desire to remain unseen by others. It changes color to blend in with its surroundings and uses its long tentacles to ensure the unwary and slay them. Like, this kind of stuff is pretty cool. Like, the ideas behind the monsters, like, their lore. That's pretty cool. I like that a lot. What the shit? It's been caught? What? An aquatic monster born when a subject drowned during testing and their consciousness became lost within Ruvik's mental world. It dwells in the murky depths and attempts to pull under anyone who draws near. Amalgam Alpha. The final consciousness of test subjects who died while connected to the stem, combined into one single horrific shape, it attacks anything that moves, attempting to flee from certain death. Heresy. A monster with a massive insect-like legs, the creature is a test subject who completely lost his identity while connected to the stem and went on a rampage, devouring the consciousness of anyone he found. Amalgam. A creature that combines the anger and animosity of the victims of Ruvik's research and his own madness. It grows larger as it absorbs the fear and hatred around it. Amalgam Core. Can't get any closer than that. Buried deep within the creature's body, Ruvik is only vulnerable when it opens its head, exposing the core. Haunted Group A. Human test subjects connected to the stem and turned into creatures by synchronizing with Ruvik's consciousness. Haunted Group B. Somehow, even people who couldn't be connected to the stem appear as monsters. Haunted Group C. Subjects retain a glimmer of their original consciousness, appearing as they did in life. However, having died in the real world, they have lost their true humanity. What? Haunted Group D. Haunted attack normal humans on sight and attempt to devour their brains, perhaps in an effort to recover their lost memories. Haunted Group E. Though they are simple-minded, some of them use weapons and tools, and some individuals appear to be driven by someone's commands. Haunted Group F. Some haunted, having a higher level of synchronization with Ruvik, wear strange masks or hoods. Animals. Birds, livestock, and other living creatures not turned into monsters are almost certainly the remnants of memories of subjects connected to the stem. Knife. Granad. Handgun, shotgun, sniper rifle, handgun automatic, magnum, agony crossbow, burst handgun, double-barreled shotgun, what? High penetration sniper rifle, RPG, brass knuckles. I'm guessing you get this stuff if you beat it on the hardest difficulty level. Choose the data you wish to play. A chapter will always be started from the beginning, even if the save game data was from partway through the chapter. Any data from partway through a chapter will not be carried over. Oh. In the bowels of the manor house, Sebastian learns of Ruvik's past and the origin of his madness. Madness!
Castellanos. Detective Castellanos.
Was that someone else's memories?
You were moaning in your sleep. Have a bad dream?
No. No. Not that way. No. Let go of me! Let go of me!
Damn it. I just want to play!
Let go of me! Let go of me!
Refrain from agitating the other. It sounds like Chris Griffin from Family Guy. Which I guess for me he sounds like Seth Green. Oh my god.
Memories are vague things indeed. It can be easy at times for memories to be distorted by others. That is why they must be cherished.
Your New Year's Eve was 7 out of 10, needed more cats. Can I go now, please?
Look as if you'd seen a ghost.
Woman! Oh, God. Please, game! I just want to shoot some weapons. Why is it so difficult? Wait, did it just autosave into... Too much effort, and I have to go. But all right, folks. Apologies for anybody just getting here. But yeah, so that was it. That wraps up The Evil Within. Fantastic. Fantastic to beat the game. The game itself was, it wasn't bad. It was a fun, mostly fun playthrough. Some frustrating moments. 14 hours, probably was a little long. Don't leave me. I might be back tonight. We'll see. We'll see how the next couple days go. But yeah. Thank you for spending some of your New Year's Day here. I appreciate it. If you enjoy the content, please consider hitting the follow button. I try to stream as often as possible. I hesitate to say daily. Especially right now when I'm on vacation, so it's a little random. But I try to be on usually in the evenings, East Coast time, scheduled below. But yeah, Evil Within. I had fun. For the most part, it was fun. I wouldn't say it was awesome. Environments for the most part were really cool. I think the ideas behind the game are cool. Execution, I guess, could be questionable in some areas. But all in all, though, it was. I think I paid $16 for it. I found it on sale. I think it was worth that. $16, $20 Yeah. If you're hesitant. If you want like a Resident Evil fix, yeah, it's along those lines. Will I be on tomorrow? I don't know. Hard to say. Maybe. Because I started back to work on Monday. I've only been back in town for a day, so I need to make sure that I get some things taken care of. So we'll see. It's possible. I didn't figure out what I'm going to play though. I probably will continue on. I don't know, we might do some, I'm thinking about either continuing on with Dragon Age Inquisition, or I might just take a break and play some Minecraft, some Mad Pack or something. Possibly, maybe. It's 100%? I don't know. But all right, guys. Thank you again, and have a good rest of your day and your week. And, yeah, I will see you next time. Meow. Toodles.